Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students. Today we are studying chapter Biochemistry of Cell. In that we are studying RNA or ribose nucleic acid, the single stranded RNA which makes proteins. RNA. Now DNA is double stranded, whereas RNA is single stranded. And you as an individual will have both DNA as well as RNA. So what is the difference between the two? How does DNA work and how does RNA work? RNA helps to make proteins. When I say proteins, you all must be thinking, what are these proteins? Simple example of proteins would be arginine, methionine, or insulin, or your growth hormones, pepsin, trypsin, all the enzymes or chemicals you can say. Now basically, whenever any enzyme or any hormone is made in your body, it is the RNA which makes. So DNA is your genetic material. The way we look is due to DNA, whereas RNA helps to make proteins. Now there are three different types of RNA. There are no types to DNA, but RNA has definitely types. The first type is mRNA, that is messenger RNA. The second type is tRNA, that is transfer RNA. And the third and the last type is ribosomal RNA. Now what are the functions of this RNA? During protein synthesis, messenger RNA or mRNA has coding information, the information to make protein. The messenger RNA forms the strand on which DNA synthesis, on which synthesis is done of the proteins. So the messenger RNA has codons or information. Now what are the functions of transfer RNA and ribosomal RNA? Transfer RNA brings the amino acids from the cytoplasm to mRNA. It does transfer, or you can say movement, from one place to another place. Now what is the function of ribosomal RNA? During protein synthesis, messenger RNA is already present. Your transfer RNA brings the amino acid, whereas ribosomal RNA attaches ribosomes, that is 30 subunit and 80S subunit, and all this together can help synthesis of protein. Now the protein synthesis process is basically called as translation. But translation doesn't happen like this. Translation goes through a pattern or through a channel. First, replication happens. Then transcription happens. When I say transcription, your DNA will have the information. But DNA says that do one thing, copy the information on some another strand, and mRNA copies the information on it. And then this process from DNA to mRNA, which is single-stranded, is called as transcription. And when your single-stranded mRNA is used to synthesize proteins, it is called as translation. RNA or ribose nucleic acid, and when I say RNA, it is single-stranded. RNA is basically genetic material of viruses. An example of this is TMV or tobacco mosaic virus. Now RNA can sometimes be genetic also. That is the reason you divide RNA into two types, that is genetic RNA and non-genetic RNA. Now genetic RNA, an example of genetic RNA would be TMV, that is tobacco mosaic virus, the virus that infects plants, sometimes cotton plants or tomato plants. Another is HIV, the very well-known virus to human beings. The genetic material of RNA is HIV. Non-genetic, mRNA, tRNA and rRNA. When I say mRNA, that is messenger RNA, tRNA is transfer RNA, and rRNA is ribosomal RNA. mRNA. The function of mRNA is it has codons, or you can say information for protein synthesis in it. All the proteins, the 20 different types of proteins synthesized in human body, the information is available on mRNA. The next form of RNA is tRNA, or you can say transfer RNA, that helps to carry. It helps to transfer amino acids from the cell cytoplasm to protein synthesis site, or the region where mRNA is present along with information. rRNA, that is ribosomal RNA. Now ribosomal RNA helps to attach 30 and 80S ribosomal subunit to mRNA so that the process of translation or protein synthesis can actually start. Central dogma. Now earlier I've said that protein synthesis is not an easy process. To make proteins, the body has to do a lot of hard work, and the hard work goes something like this. First, DNA is formed, or you are present in the cell with DNA. DNA undergoes replication, that is copy, and along with that, DNA does transcription. When I say transcription, the information which is present as coded language on DNA is copied on mRNA. DNA, which was double-stranded, is converted into mRNA, which is single-stranded. And this process is called transcription. Now, once transcription is done, what happens is mRNA is converted into proteins. And these proteins could be all your hormones, enzymes, for example, adrenaline, non-adrenaline, insulin, all of them. The process of translation forms a case or forms the parameter or forms the basis of protein synthesis. So this is the central dogma for protein synthesis. I hope you all have understood what protein synthesis is and what are the different types of mRNA involved in it. Thank you.